Now let's find out the electric field due to a long uniformly charged wire by using Gauss's theorem. So if this is a very long uniformly charged wire which is charged with a linear charge density lambda coulomb per meter, and say from this wire at some distance, at some radial distance, we are required to find the electric field at a point. Then by using Gauss's law, we need to consider a Gaussian surface such that the point where we wish to find out the electric field will lie on the Gaussian surface, as well as at every point of the surface, the electric field is either parallel or perpendicular to the surface. Let's consider a cylindrical Gaussian surface in this situation, as we can see it here. And in this situation, point P is the point located on the lateral surface of the cylindrical Gaussian surface where we are required to find the electric field. In this situation, we can also see that the Gaussian surface, its name we write as M, and the cylindrical Gaussian surface is of radius R and its length is L. Then by symmetry, we can say if we split the surface in three parts, first, second and third. Here first and third part are the circular sections of the cylindrical surface and second part is the lateral section of the cylindrical surface. In this situation, if we just have a look on the electric field at every point on the lateral surface, if we consider an element of area ds, its ds vector and electric field vector, both will be parallel to each other. And on the side circular faces, we can see area vector and electric field vector are perpendicular to each other. Same phenomena will take place here on the section 3, where ds vector is normal to the surface and electric field vector is parallel to the surface. Now in this situation, if we apply Gauss's law on surface M, then directly we can see the total flux coming out from the surface M can be written as integral E dot ds for the closed surface equals to total enclosed charge by epsilon naught. And in this situation, within this Gaussian surface, a total length L of the line charge is enclosed. So here we can write that Q enclosed is equals to lambda L. So here the total flux calculation can also split up in three parts, that is integration of E dot ds for the section 1 plus integration of E dot ds for the section 2 plus integration of E dot ds for the section 3, which is equal to total enclosed charges lambda L by epsilon naught. Now in this situation, if we just have a look on section 1 and 3, here we can see that electric field and area vector are normal to each other. So the dot product will vanish. In this situation, first and third integrals will become 0 because E and ds are perpendicular to each other. For the second section, we can see at every point E and ds are parallel. And by symmetry, we can see that E is uniform at every point on the surface. So it is E integration of ds for the section 2 is equals to lambda L by epsilon naught. And here total integral of the elemental area over the surface is the total area of the lateral surface of the cylindrical section. So this will be written as 2 pi r L, which is equals to lambda L by epsilon naught. Here L gets cancelled out and the value of electric field will be lambda by 2 pi epsilon naught r, which can also be written as 2k lambda by r. This is the result which we already calculated in electrostatic, but in a different way. And here we have calculated the result by using Gauss's theorem.